Hey guys, so this is a video, and I'm refilming this because my iPad decided to go berserk on me. But this is a video on my vacay in Temecula, California. I'm gonna try to make it brief and quick for you guys, okay? So I stayed two nights at South Coast Winery's Resort and Spa. It's a bit of a mouthful, but I'm not affiliated professionally with this company in any way, shape, or form. This is completely my personal opinion and my personal review on the place that I went to. Now, the reason I chose Temecula Wineries is because it's inside of Southern California, or within. It's a third of the distance as opposed to me going to Vegas, which I was thinking about. And it's practically like it's like two-thirds of the price, okay? So I was comparing the two because I was like, hey, I want to go somewhere. It was for my boyfriend's birthday, actually. And let's see, the average Vegas hotel at the time, or right now I should say, because I just went over the weekend, was like $200, $300, and that's like cheap, unless you wanted to stay at like a Four Seasons. No, not even. Do you, any of you guys believe Four Seasons is actually one of the highest rated hotels in Las Vegas? I didn't know that. News to me. But anyway, so I ended up picking Temecula because it's closer, cheaper. Why not? I've never been wine tasting before either. So what is so surreal about this is the fact that you're literally kind of driving up this road, and it's originally like regular city outlet stores, blah, 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 and all of a sudden it just opens up and it's just all like grapevines and buildings every few miles. It's crazy. Like, I thought it was the coolest thing ever because I was like, whoa, no buildings. So the place that I stayed at was, if you can compare it to Vegas, it was small. The hotel alone was only three stories, and they had villas too. They have like a lot of villas though. And I wanted to stay at one so badly, but unfortunately I booked so last minute that they were completely out of them. So I ended up just going with the hotel room, but their hotel rooms are brand new. They're literally just finished within, I think, this year. So it wasn't bad at all. I had a nice king-size bed with a bedroom and a sitting room. It has the fridge. It has that I can actually use and have all that little weird food stuff in it that I'm not going to eat. And then it had the Keurig coffee machine. Amazing, amazing bathtub. Guys, I'm going to tell you guys right now, if I do another vacay review, I go to places for bathtubs because I love taking baths. Like, not that I don't have a bathtub at home, but I'm just, it's one of those things, I like the big, deep, jacuzzi-sized bathtubs. This was for real one of them. Like, I've stayed at the Mandarin Oriental, which is my favorite Vegas hotel, stayed at Aria, stayed at MGM, like, whatever, you know? This, like, was so much nicer than it, the room at least. Maybe not the Mandarin, but the bathtub was bigger. So, I absolutely loved it. It was so nice. It was very nice and clean, too. The room service came every day. Granted, it's only three stories, so they don't got much to clean. But then again, they had villas. But we did have our own private balcony. We had, just a lot of stuff. And what I love, my package was for 2 days, right? So Thursday and Friday. Granted, Thursday is going to be cheaper because it counts as a weekday. But I paid a total of $548. My package included two breakfasts. So I got it the middle, second day that I was there, and then the day I was about to leave. I got a bottle of wine upon arriving at the room, and it was 05 Merlot from that winery. I got we had the wine tasting and tour, and that was, had five wines. So we started off the tour with a sparkling red, and then during the tour, or at the end of the tour, I should say, we had wine and food pairings. So we had for our wines, a red, a white, a rosé, and a champagne. And then for the foods, we had a cheddar cheese, brie cheese, blue cheese, a soda cracker for a palate cleanser, and then strawberry and grape. I'm going to tell you guys right now, I usually do not like blue cheese in any way, shape, or form, but that was, oh my gosh, try blue cheese with red wine. It tastes so good. It's weird, okay? So I was like loving that. So I had that, and it was really funny because our tour guide got drunk by the end of it because he's like this older guy. I don't think he can handle his alcohol anymore. So, excuse me. So it was kind of funny with that. They do also have, like, they promote, like, their, I guess it's like a yearly wine club thing, but oh my gosh, the place is so gorgeous. Like, the 2 days I was there, there was two weddings going on, but it's understandable because it's so private. Like, there's no loud noises, but you're so close to the city, so everyone can get to it and everything. Like, I just thought it was amazing. And service was great too. I mean, you have to understand, getting there, it was kind of junky, I guess you could say, because I mean, there's no valet parking. There is a bellhop and everything, but it's like you're so close to the hotel, there's no need for them unless you have a mess of stuff. Front desk was really, really nice. They're always there to just assist with whatever you needed and stuff. And what I love is not only did I get a bottle of wine upon arriving, I actually got a case of wine when I left too. So for my case, this is the wine that I got. It's an 06 Cabernet Sauvignon, also from their winery. And I was amazed. I was like gonna be happy with an 08, but this is actually an 06. Like, pretty crazy. And what is it? Wild Horse Peak is just one of the vineyards that the owner owns. He actually owns like 3 or 4 of the local vineyards in Temecula. So I thought that was pretty crazy. I have not tried this one yet. I drank the 05 Merlot, which is what they gave us at first. Oh my gosh, okay, that stuff was so ridiculously dry. But then I let it air out and I let it cool down more, and I have to say it wasn't that bad. And I'm gonna tell you right now, I actually got buzzed off of wine. Never in my life has that ever happened. I didn't know that was happened or able to happen. But I'm just like, I guess it is alcoholic still. So, that's basically about it. I mean, not too much. What I really, really liked about staying there was that we ate at the restaurant and everything. Their food was pretty darn good. Like, even, granted, with the, breakfast, we had, like, this set menu, but it was, I mean, I tried, there was no way I could have finished all the stuff, because they had, like, different types, and, oh, it was a mimosa breakfast, too. So, I had mimosas for breakfast for 2 days. Good thing I was not driving anywhere, because holy cow, I've never had that much alcohol before, like constantly throughout a day, I should say. But what I loved is that even though we're in a winery area, if you just drive like 10 minutes down, it's Civilization. There's CVS, Target, whatever that you needed. Oh my gosh. And if you guys go to Temecula, to winery, look up a place called Gourmet Italia. It's literally super close to the freeway when you get off. This is the most authentic Italian place I have ever been to. I would drive an hour just to eat there. That's how good it is, okay? Pricing, not that expensive. I mean, your average, like, $10, $15 for an Italian. If you want to get their really nice food, it's, like, pricier, so it's, like, $30. But, oh my god, okay, the waiters all spoke Italian, like, actual fluent Italian, which is really funny, too, though, because the waiter that I got was so Italian, he barely spoke English, which is, had a bit of trouble there, but otherwise, not too bad. Food was amazingly delicious, okay? I got a salmon bow tie pasta, but it was actually, he described it as, oh, the salmon's actually in the sauce. It's not actual salmon. I was like, oh, okay, I'll try it. So it's literally, okay, I think what it is, it's a salmon emulsion. So it's bow tie pasta mixed with capers, and it has a salmon, and I think it's emulsified with extra virgin olive oil and some seasoning, but it also had smoked salmon in there. Holy cow, guys, I had to like keep myself from eating all of it because I was like, I really want to save this. It's one of those things that you want to really savor, and oh my god, so good. Okay, we had dessert after that, and what's really funny is the Italian place is a little hole in a wall place next to a Hawaiian food place called Maui Waui or whatever like that, but go to the Italian place, you will not regret it, okay? So that's basically my review. If I left anything out, let me know. But, I mean, I have to say, I enjoyed it. I mean, the winery place is definitely a nice place to stay and relax and just get away from the city. So if you guys live in SoCal, check out your local winery. Thanks for watching the video. I am going to make another video after this for my current workout routine and things like that. So if you guys are interested, please be sure to watch. Any questions, always inbox me. You know I will reply. Bye!